Good afternoon, everybody. This is Brother Lloyd. And to those who are keeping the Sabbath today, I'll be having a blessed and peaceful Sabbath day. Now, the first thing I wanted to do today was share a letter that I received from one of my followers. I read it and it was, to me, it was powerful. And I said, you know what? I'm just going to share it with those who follow my videos because it's something that that some of us need to have a better understanding of. And this person hit on it quite well, so I'm going to share the letter. And it starts like this. It goes, "Hello Lloyd, did you ever do a video on graven images? I think I have. I'm probably sure I have, if not once, twice." It says, "I notice a lot of people who claim to be believers surround themselves with all sorts of graven images and things in heaven. Angel statues, things on earth, dog statues, stuffed bears, Barbie dolls, as little graven human beings. And things under the earth, figurines of clamshells and dolphins. God didn't just say, don't worship graven images. He commanded us not to make them for ourselves. Thou shalt not make unto thee any graven image or any likeness of anything that is in the heaven above or that is in the earth beneath or that is in the water under the earth." That's how the scripture reads, Exodus 20 and verse 4. Also, Leviticus 26, 1. Deuteronomy 4:16, 23:25, 5:8, 7:5, and 7:25 also state this commandment. It is not simply the Catholic Church that does this stuff, but many believers flood their homes and lives with graven images. Let me stop right there for a second. We are all very familiar, well, some of us are very familiar with the idolatry in the Catholic Church, the papacy. They are loaded with it. You see it. Everything about them is idolatry. From all the garb they wear, the staffs, the crowns, the everything, the statues, they're loaded with it. And it's easy to pile on and point out the idolatry in the Roman Catholic system, and not the people. The people just follow what they believe. But it's easy to pile on to that and point out all their idolatry, but in reality, everyone, for the most part, is full of idolatry, and this letter is pointing that out to a great degree. Continue on. "When God convicted my heart of this secret sin, I repented of it and began to throw away any graven image made in the likeness of something God created in heaven, on earth, or underneath the water, or underneath the earth in the water. But the commandment extends to any graven thing made by an act of mankind that is made not unto God, but unto ourselves, replacing that which is due God. The exception was with the tabernacle of God described in Exodus 25, since it was made unto God in obedience to him and not, as Exodus 24 and countless other scriptures relays, that we shall not make for ourselves any graven image. The world is addicted to graven images, and the people they attack most heavily are children through toys and arts and crafts." Interesting word there, crafts, witchcraft, all that mess. "At school, which appear innocent to blind mankind, but are in fact idolatry, and therefore are absolute abomination against God. Believers need to get rid of their idols, especially those that have been formed as an act of mankind by tossing them in the fire and destroying them in some other way. As long as we have them, even presumptuously, we are sinning against God. I pray that this message receives you well, believer in Christ." Now, let me say this. The individual who wrote this letter has really gotten into trying to understand and figure out what idolatry is all about. And they've pretty much hit the nail on the head. Now, to some of you, the lengths at which people go to remove things from out of their lives which they perceive as idolatry may seem extreme, but there's a lot of accuracy in it. We idolize and worship so many things, and then we let our children go out into these systems, school systems, etc., and become indoctrinated by more of these things. Symbolism is huge. We have our children, ourselves, and everyone worshiping, idolizing all these things. And like I always say, the enemy puts this stuff right in our face, and people deny it through their actions and through their own belief systems. We do things like we watch all this television and think nothing of it. But that becomes an idol within itself, just the television box. And then on top of that, we're indoctrinated by a lot of the things that are on it. So if we're not careful, we get caught up in that. We get addicted to shows like American Idol. See, the enemy puts the stuff right there, idol. I want you to idolize this. And people by the gazillions flock to watch that show every time it comes on. Just simple things like that. People have all these statues of the so-called savior in their home, crucifixes with the semblance of a man on it, to which most perceive is our savior, and they wear it and they hang it on the walls and all these things. This is idolatry. People focus on all these statues and figurines and all this mess, just like back in the days with Jacob. There was a big part of that story which focused on idolatry and taught us about idolatry, but people still don't get it. People want to hang on to everything that represents something that they believe in, and everything that we idol is a false god. So we have to work on coming away from idolizing these false images. This is why the word says some of the things that it says according to the letter that this individual wrote me. We have to move all these statues of whatever from our homes. When you look at them and they're statues of individuals and things that represent gods and all this, people caught up in symbolism on their clothing and all this stuff. And you have entertainers and stuff out there pushing all this stuff, and yet in their messages, they tell you what they worship. They believe in Satan, they believe in this and the other, and they have their clothing lines and stuff with all their own symbols and logos, and all that stuff is mired in satanic worship and stuff. But people by the millions run out and buy these individuals' clothing lines and all this stuff, and they become part of that system. They start idolizing these people and the things that they represent. The word is clear, people. As an individual, it's up to you. You have to study the word and not be afraid and intimidated by what it's telling us. It doesn't imply anything. The word is clear. It says do and don't. If you choose to manipulate it to your own self-satisfaction, that's what you choose to do. The word is very clear about things we should and shouldn't do. The Father doesn't want us to get sidetracked with the works of the enemy. This is why he has drawn hard lines about what we should and shouldn't do. But anyway, I just wanted to share that letter with you, and just thank the individual that wrote it to me, because it's a very profound letter and it's very powerful as far as I'm concerned. And with that, I'm out. Thank you.